right on schedule, so that's good. So the B2Stage hands-on session. So far we've been mostly talking about B2Safe, using B2Safe, joining B2Safe. And as you could see in the slides also shown by Christine, when using B2Safe, it's about the first step is about ingesting data from your client to the iRoads instance. And in the morning session, we focus on the iCommands. In the context of B2Stage, EUDOT also supports another protocol, GridFTP, which is an alternative to or the extension of the FTP protocol, which is focused on high performance data transfers. So first, a little bit of background about B2Stage and how this GridFTP fits into the B2Stage service. So B2Stage itself, as we've seen in the introduction this morning, is focused at moving large amounts of data, especially between data stores and high performance compute resources, HPC systems. And in that workflow, it also supports ingesting the results of your high performance analysis back into EUDOT. And the same approach of ingesting data back into EUDOT can also be used in the using B2Safe scenario, since when B2Stage moves the data back into EUDOT, it moves it back into B2Stage. By using GridFTP in B2Stage, it really supports depositing of large data sets. And the features are, because it's based on GridFTP high-speed transfers, I think that's the main feature of using GridFTP. As we've already mentioned, how does it fit in the full picture? So on the one side, B2Safe offers the storage and PID management, and B2Stage offers another way of ingesting data into B2Safe or get it out. So it really is on this intersection between B2Safe and the high performance compute environment. So what are the possibilities of using B2Stage? So it's heavily based on the Globus Online toolkit and the GridFTP protocol, which is provided by Globus Online. So the first mechanism of using B2Stage is the Globus Online service, which is basically a hosted service which you can use for high performance transfers between a client and a data center, or between two data centers directly. Another possibility is using the GridFTP command line client, and that's the one we will be focusing on in the hands-on session. There's a data staging script, which is basically a wrapper around the GridFTP command. And the last option, but that's a work in progress, is the HTTP interface, which could also be really interesting to all the Clarine centers, that at when this HTTP interface into the EUDOT domain becomes available, that will be quite a nice way of interacting. But yeah, it's still under development, so we're not there yet. What you can see with all options is that there's basically two channels of communication. One is the control channel, where you basically control connecting from the client to the server or server to server to the authentication. And there's the data flow channel, which is aimed at parallelizing the data transfers in order to achieve the best performance. So how does it work and how does it fit into the iRoads setup? So what we've seen so far is that we have the iRoads server. Next to the iRoads server, you have to install the GridFTP server with a special DSI component. We will see more of that later. And this DSI component is basically the piece of software that enables the GridFTP server to store the data into iRoads. And for the rest, the service uses the B2Safe functionality to do all the PID management and those kind of things. And a client can typically send data directly to the grid FTP server, or as shown in this picture, do a server-to-server transfer. So if the server, both servers really have a fast connection, this is probably a better solution than doing a client-to-server transfer. For the hands-on session, we will be focusing on the client, which will use the remote grid FTP server to ingest data. It's a little bit easier than the server-to-server use case, and this will also apply to the using B2Save scenario. So on this side, the client will be the client on the repository side with the repository file system, and this will be the EU.data ingest node where B2Save and the grid FTP server are running. So this is some information about the where you can find the DSI component. IROTS is just a plain IROTS installation. Grid FTP is a plain grid FTP installation, and the DSI component is what uses the IROTS microservices to communicate with your IROTS file system. So if you look at the overview, which Christine has also used several times, what we will be focusing on initially is getting data from the client into the IROTS server. The IROTS server that we will be using is called Alice. But instead of having only B2Save installed, it also has the grid FTP server running there with this DSI component. We have to see how fast you will be. If this is all working, we can see if we can improve the ingestion process a little bit, which is also similar to what we did this morning. And for the really advanced users, they can even try to, after ingesting, also replicate to another site. But we have to see if time allows. So I've made all material available on GitHub. So if you go to github.com/WilhelmElbers/b2save-gridftp, there will be a file hands-on.md with all the instructions of installing the requirements, the gridftp client, and all the instructions about how to obtain your credentials. We basically have two options. Again, you can install locally if you're running a Debian Linux environment. Otherwise, you can use the client virtual machine at this address with basically the same credentials that you used this morning. So IROTS 1 to 10 with the passwords IROTS 1 December to IROTS 10 December. Did everybody open the GitHub page? Because then I will move to the next slide. So here's all the information you basically need. So this is the virtual machine if you use, I've done two slides, that's not really nice. But if you use the client VM to do the hands-on session, you should start with section 1.2 on the GitHub page. If you want to install everything locally, you have to start with section 1.1 on the GitHub page. And this is all the information of the servers you need with all the credentials.